On a minute, Frank. How are you going to build a spaceship?
Maybe you're right. Well, hold on a minute. Listen. First, I'll learn how to build a spaceship.
Very good.
Then I'll build a spaceship.
Very good.
And then we'll all go out into outer space together and we'll have great adventures.
You know, I think Frank hasn't really come home from the pictures yet. Of course, you know what we could do? We could all pretend it's real.
Oh, well, let's do that then, will we?
Could we? That'd be great. Here we go.
Here we go. We don't know where, but we are on our way. Off to fly through the sky. When we get there, we won't stay. We will travel so far that we'll visit every star. We will search far and wide on our interstellar ride.
Past the moon, and then soon we will wave the sun goodbye.
Outer space is the place where we all intend to fly.
We don't know what's out there, and we're much too brave to dare. We will fight a new foe, 'cause we're heroes, don't you know?
Well, now, can you guess what today's tongue twister is all about, Bosco?
I bet it's all about spaceships.
I wonder however did he guess that. Are you ready to say the tongue twister with me? Here it is. Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering, shooting stars.
Oh, nice tongue twister, he said. Let me try. Will you help me? Right. Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. Did I get it right?
You did. I think it's my turn now. Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. I wonder how the tongue twister's like living away out there in space.
Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. Psh! Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. Psh! Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. Psh! Speeding spaceships sometimes seem like shiny, shimmering shooting stars. Psh!
Help!
Oh,
excuse me.
Yeah, it's a problem.
What's all this for, Frank?
Can you not see, Bosco? I'm trying to build a spaceship.
Don't worry, Bosco. I didn't realise it either.
No, listen. Every spaceship has to have a pilot, a navigator, and a gunner at the back, and I want to be the gunner.
Well, can I be the pilot then?
Well, that makes Bosco the navigator then.
Oh, excuse me. But what do I do? What does it mean?
What that means is that you tell us which star degree to take and you warn us if the enemy are going to attack. Here's your hat.
Oh, I see. So that you can fight them, Frank.
Well, that's the idea.
Oh,
now,
good.
Are we ready?
Yes.
Right. All systems go and ready for takeoff.
We are fully prepared, Captain.
Skies clear and course in order. Ready when you are, Captain.
Right. Here we go.
Hooray! We're off to
right.
The moon.
Flight to planet Mars now in progress. Could we have a pilot's report, please?
We are about to arrive at planet Mars at 23, 24,
25, 02, Captain. Danger! Danger! Enemy starship in space! Behind us and they're gaining speed! Oh, do you know what? This could be dangerous.
All systems on the alert. Enemy approaching. Ready to take action. Ready to take action. Enemy approaching.
Enemy starship behind us. Danger, 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 danger.
Okay, okay, here we go. Take evasive action and prepare to engage enemy.
Vroom, 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 vroom.
Here we go. I think I see him on the site. That's it, that's it. Got him, got him. Yeah, another slimy bites the dust. To
who? Oh, this is great fun. I never knew it was so easy to build a spaceship.
I think we
Listen,
better.
This is no time for levity. Stand by your post, Navigator.
I think we'd better take a story while Frank comes back to Earth again. What do you think, Fosco?
I think we should have a look at the Plumsters to see what they're up to. I think they are the most space-like people I've ever seen. Maybe that's what people in space really look like.
Yep. Oh, hello. Hello.
You think that outer space is a great place to live, wouldn't you?
Maybe it is!
Maybe it isn't. Did you ever think of what outer space is really like?
Well, actually, I don't really know much about it.
Well, if I told you this poem about outer space, you might realise it's not so great at all.
Oh.
Do you want to hear it?
Yes, please. Thank you.
I'd hate to live in outer space. It's very cold out there. And furthermore, I've heard it said, there isn't any air. If you go out in outer space, you just can't wear a coat. And furthermore, spacesuit or not, you can't just walk, you float. It's always dark in outer space. I don't think that's so good. You'd never rise from bed because you can't tell when you should. The one thing about outer space that I can gladly bear is that I'm nice and cozy here. And it is far out there.
Well, maybe it isn't such a wonderful place after all. But you know, Marion, I hope Frank comes back down to Earth when he goes behind the magic door today.
Right, are you ready to come through the magic door with me? Right, can you remember the rhyme? Because you have to say it to make the magic work. Knock, knock, open wide, see what's on the other side. Knock, knock, anymore, come with me for the magic door.
Black sheep too, like heaven. So fib.
Okay. Well, will the three of us sing it together?
Yes.
Will you help us, Evelyn? You're very good at singing it. Mm. One, two, three.
Ba, ba, black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, yes, sir, three bags full. One for the master and one for the dame. One for the little boy who lives down the lane.
That was very good. Oh, Evelyn, where did you get that beautiful necklace?
I got it off Mummy.
Off who?
Mummy.
Off your mummy? Oh, that was very nice. What did you get off Santa Claus?
I got a little big baby.
Did you? What did you get, Mark?
I got a kicker and a rough rider and a torch.
Did you? What do you do with the torch?
Switching on and off on the night times.
Oh, that's very good. Can you look at books with it?
Pardon?
Do you look at books with it?
You look at it in the morning.
Oh,
yeah, when it's very dark and you can't see, you have to look out with the torch because there's a light inside it. It's just like a light.
Oh, that's great. I love one of those. Well, you know what?
What?
I have to go. But I thank you very much for coming to see me, and I'll see you again soon. All right?
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Aren't they nice?
Yeah, I like
the
necklace.
They're my friends.
Evelyn's necklace was lovely, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think she must have a very nice mother. Oh, where's Frank?
Hello, I'm here.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm Frank.
Something just came into my head.
What was it?
There's something that we're forgetting.
What?
Well, we can't have any adventures with space monsters if we don't have space monsters, can we?
Oh,
that's true. So what are we going to do?
Well, I think the simple answer will be that we'll make our own space monsters.
I know, we could draw a kind of monsters that we could imagine that live in space.
That's
right. Oh, right. Will you start then?
Right, will I go ahead then?
Off you go,
Frank. Okay. Well, that'll give you a hint when I said go ahead, because I think that the first thing a space monster should have is two heads.
Oh, two, not just one.
Right, we'll give him a body first here.
A squiggly body.
Squiggly body and an eye there in the middle of his belly.
In his tummy. Yeah. An eye in his tummy.
An eye in his tummy.
What's that for?
Well, when he,
so that he can see everything all the time.
No, well, I was going to say, when his other four eyes are closed, he can keep an eye out for you.
That gives me an idea, an eye out. I'm going to know what I'm going to do with my monster.
Right, there's his two heads, and we'd better give him a few hands, would you think?
Oh, yes.
Loads of hands, because monsters are always trying to grab at everything, aren't they?
Oh, Frank, you know, that's a really nasty monster. I wouldn't like to meet him.
Would you not?
No.
I wouldn't either, really, I think.
He might give me a fright.
That's lovely. Can I do one now?
You can do one. What are you going to do?
Well, you mentioned there an eye out, so can I have the white one?
The white one. There you go.
It's my favourite colour. You mentioned the eye out, right?
Right.
She broke the crayon!
Mine is going to have an eye out and he's always on the lookout. Really nosy.
Looking out to the side of his head!
On a big long tube like that. Right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Now, I think I'll give him two teensy little eyes. One there.
Yeah. And where's his other one?
One there.
Right.
And then a squiggly nose.
I think monsters that live in space must need an awful lot of eyes.
And fangs like this so that he can eat his dinner. In case he gets hungry.
I wonder, does he clean his teeth?
And then just one big squiggly ear. And that's it.
Do you know what I was thinking?
What?
I was thinking that we should give them names.
That's a good idea.
That's a great idea. Well, now, have you any ideas, Bosco, as to what we should call them?
Now, let me see. We couldn't call them any ordinary names.
No, we can't make up
silly monster type of names. Frank, what was the nasty in the space film called?
The nasty in the space film was called Darth the Gork.
Well, then we could call Frank's monster...
This is my fella, yeah.
Grunt the Glob.
Very good. I like that.
What about my one? Can you think of a name for mine? My little dolt.
Wait till I think of another gooey name. How about Wirple the Luke.
Oh, that's lovely, yeah. That's Wirble there.
That's great. Well, listen now. We've got our space monsters.
Yes.
We've got our spaceship.
Yes.
And I think we should have a story about a space adventure.
Oh, you? Okay. I love that. And if you've got one.
I have one. Right, just for you.
No.
It was another boring day in outer space. The stars were flying by, and Bop Steedle, the space hero, hadn't fought a monster for ages and ages. He was sitting back, looking at his robot Snoot, wondering if he should take him apart and put him back together again, well, just for the sake of doing something. Snoot knew what his master was thinking, and so he was really relieved to say, "Unknown craft heading towards us at 3,000 miles per second, sir." "Oh, good," said Boop, grabbing the controls of his ship and preparing to fire. "I'm receiving a distress signal from the craft, sir," Snoot said. "Shouldn't you talk to them before you blast them out of the sky?" Boop was a bit disappointed at this and he said, "All right, if you insist." And he tuned into intergalactic band and said, "Hello, calling mystery craft, hello." In a moment, a trembling little voice came back, just saying, "Help, help. You'll have to tell me more than that," Boop said, "or I'll have no choice but to blow you up. Help, help. I don't know how to work this ship," the trembling little voice called back.
Oh, the poor little thing must have been very frightened not knowing how to work the ship.
Well, would you be frightened if you were stuck out in space and you didn't know how to work the ship?
Well, what, of course.
Well, and I would too. "Oh, all right," Boop said, still wishing that he could just press the trigger and blast the ship. Well, the only good thing about it was that he could start pulling some really smart stunts of dodging and weaving at hyperspace speeds so that he could play tag with the master ship and finally catch up with it. Snoot, however, didn't like those sort of things. Whenever his master started showing off, the robot would hide behind one of the seats and hope not to end up with his microchips all over the star system. Well, with lots of spins and turns, Boop Steedle finally caught up on the mystery ship and he sent out grips from the bottom of his craft to grab it and hold it back. Then he put on his spacesuit and he took a short space hop over into the mystery ship.
Frank, I'd love to put on a spaceship and go out into outer space.
I would too, and maybe we'll do that someday, will we?
We might.
Right. Inside, to his surprise, he found a very nervous and upset creature, 3 foot high and 6 arms wide. It was sitting at the controls of the ship, trembling.
"What do I do?"
the creature cried.
"What do I do?"
Well, Boop didn't say anything. He just flicked the off switch and everything was still. And he was thinking to himself how it would have been much more fun to blast the mystery ship to nothing.
Oh, when... I wouldn't like if he did that, Frank.
No, I wouldn't like... I wouldn't like if he did it either.
No.
Well, when Snoot dropped in with all his alarm lights flashing, "Excuse me, sir," he said. "I don't wish to alarm you, but there's a spaceship the size of 2 planets heading this way, armed and ready to annihilate us." Boop didn't often get scared, but this was definitely one of those times. He was scanning his mind for ideas on how he might disappear when he heard the deepest, loudest, roughest, roaring voice he'd ever heard come bellowing through the ship. "Junior! Junior!
Oh, Frank!
Are you all right?
Oh, I hope it's not going to be some terrible monster on the ship."
"No, wait till I tell you.
All
Do you
right.
know who it was?
What?
You know, it was the Mammy." "Oh, yes, Mammy, thank you," the little creature said back. "This nice man saved me. Thank you, stranger," said the booming voice from the enormous ship. "You're very welcome. Any time at all. My pleasure entirely," said Boop, rattling in his black leather knee boots. "Now come along, Junior. You'll have to go back to bed early for taking your toy ship into outer space instead of playing in here." Well, Boop, Steedle and Snoot climbed back into their own ship and they watched the monster ship take the little one away.
Oh, goodbye. Bye. I'm glad you're going home nice and safe.
Safe and sound. Well, Boop realised that he didn't feel quite so bored anymore. In fact, he thought that he had a nice long rest.
Oh, I really love that story.
Yeah, I'm glad everything...
Thanks very much for telling it to me.
Not at all. Listen, I'm glad everything turned out for the best in the end. Are you?
Oh, I am, because I wouldn't wouldn't like to get lost in space.
I wouldn't either. Hello.
Hi. I thought it would be a good idea if we made our own spaceship.
Oh, great. Can I help?
You can more than help, Frank. There's lots to do.
Oh, is there?
Tell you what you need first of all. Put down that paper just in case we get around to
painting.
In
case we make a mess.
Oh, right. Yes.
All you need.
You can't always keep the place in the mess. You have to try and keep it tidy.
All you need are old cartons. Anything will do. Old cheese boxes, tea boxes.
Yeah. And the insides of some
toilet rolls.
Great.
So we'll just tape this big box down.
That's going to be the big part, is it?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'll hand that over to you.
Right. And we'll start off now. What do we do first? We put this on, I think.
Well, it can be as mad as you like.
To make it look a bit gorgeous.
Oh, Frank, what's that going to be?
Well, that can be the canteen. A canteen where all the space monsters go and have their dinner. Right?
I wonder what they have for dinner.
Put this as a lookout tower, Frank.
Right, a lookout tower. We'll put that over there. Can I have another piece of sellotape? Right, a lookout tower.
No. Isn't sticky tape great stuff?
And then two beady little eyes, or one beady little eye. There.
Okay.
I never knew spaceship had eyes.
And make it stay on.
Maybe there. You need a larger piece of sellotape.
I do.
Careful with the scissors, Marianne.
Yeah, you should get a grown-up to help you if you're using the scissors. There you go.
No, I put... Do you want another beady little eye?
Yeah.
Did you say two? Right.
We good?
No. Right, what's next?
I think you should stick some other things onto the side parts of it because I think they look a bit bare.
There?
Yeah.
Right.
That's it. That could be a big window
so you could
see all the stars and things.
Yeah, be good too. No.
This could be...
We put that over here again.
Another
lookout tower for this side. Just in case anyone was coming up behind you and you wouldn't see them, would you?
I wouldn't like that, Frank. I think I'd spend all my time in the lookout tower so I could see if there were any enemy spaceships approaching.
That's certainly looking unusual anyway, Frank.
That's right, you were the navigator, weren't you?
That's
right, you'd be looking out all the time.
Maybe you should put a little chair for the pilot then up
a
the
chair?
Front.
A chair? A chair. Well, what'll we use for a chair?
This looks like a chair.
Okay, let's put that there. Now, and when all this is done, you could start to paint this.
Mad colours.
Do you know what?
What?
It's time for us to say goodbye to all the boys and girls now.
Is it? We'll see you soon.
We'll be seeing you soon. Have fun making your spaceship.
Bye.
Bye.
Here we are, Bosco. We're working very hard today. Polishing forks and spoons. No time for playing, I'm afraid.
Nope, it's all work today, Bosco.
Mm-hmm. music. What's all the noise for, Bosco?
I'm making music, too.
Hold on a minute, Bosco. If you play it more quietly and more slowly, maybe we can hear the music then. Wait till we come over to you. Three of us together, after three. Five. You ready?
Yes.
A hen, a bow, a two. Music everywhere. There really is. Listen to the music of water, and birds, and bees, and horses' hooves.